Like I said, most of the fights and combat that you guys are going to get into are not going to happen on a football field or in a school yard. Right? They're going to happen in small areas. Now, you guys all saw how kind of like laws and news and everything that was coming here, because I should get a little bit better at it, and I can break it down more for you. You've got to be a move that rotates after a move. Eventually, when it becomes freestyle, it's not really freestyle, because you've got to break up the motions and recreate. But also, you may find yourself in that freestyle in a move, is where I come in, where you get to a full Nelson on the ground, and you're stuck there, and you're laying flat. You may want to stay there, and you may want to call me. Right? And say, I don't know what the heck to do. Or if you decide to just lift yourself up, then the person has to release you and recreate the move. You can't stay there. So it all depends on what you're going to do, and that's how you do learn. Right? By being patient. So I come by and I'll say, okay, you need to put your arm out over here, bring your knee up here, move this here, boom, and you say, oh! And then the same happens to you again, you can't do it. Alright? And that's why it's great to recreate or let the guy move. Loosen up your grip so you can keep going. You understand takedowns, you'll understand when you're too hard and you're too stiff. You should be softer, you should be have more movement. Now, both of those zones come together in mortal combat. Okay? Most of you want to try to keep your zones in the yellow zone where you're actually doing what we're doing in the next class, which is the chops, the hitting from a distance. But, okay? You got a guy that's hyper energy in front of you, like Chi-Man. You ever had the ability to stand in front of Chi-Man? Or if you got a guy in front of you that's 290 pounds, he's just pure violent energy, maybe your chops aren't going to work too well on him. Right? Unless you start to combine, this all leads in. So you need both formulas. Right? You're going to look at Shaolin as kind of like a math. You know? You need both formulas to work. Most of you, attacked, if you're going to be attacked, hopefully your awareness abilities keep you from being attacked. And I can tell you a lot of stories about that. But you could be sitting down at the bus stop, somebody come behind you, grab you, put you in a headlock, and have a knife to your throat. That's more reality if you're not aware. And we all could be taken unaware. You know, you walk in, you talk to somebody, you turn the wrong corner, there's a gang there, which has happened to somebody, there's a gang there that they need to initiate themselves, and they stab you 7 times. You just turn the wrong corner. And you walk on the wrong side of the street where they were. Maybe if I turn the corner, I can peg these guys and say, you know, I'm going to walk over here. Let's look at the next guy. You know, if I say, or I'm going to be ready for it, or I'm not going to be ready for it. Okay? So there's a lot of stuff that comes out there that this comes in. But the hardest part to really learn from it, you have to try and work as a team. Right? One motion follows off another motion. And then when you're good, you can constantly manipulate their movement and motion. And that's where they learn as well. So when you're working with someone that really has it, you really get a lot of benefits from it. Otherwise, it just turns to a lot of sloth. So what you've got to try and do, as I said, like get to a full Nelson, you've got him on the ground, you know, then if he moves, you've got to let him go. If he stops, you know, the person stops and says, hey man, I keep really trapped. Call Susan. Say, hey, how would I get out of this? And I would say, well, I'm probably going to die. Alright, so you're dead, so don't worry about it. No. And then we'll show ways how you could manipulate the harmful movement. And you've got to see one motion counters into two emotions. So it's kind of like a spider on its victim, and it constantly expands, contracts, expands, contracts. You kind of want to keep that whole yin and yang motion through everything that you're doing. You've got expanding and contracting. Work as a team. That's how you develop technique. So when you do get grabbed, you know, and you understand, you bring all those variables in, you feel like another planet. And if anybody in the past years had the pleasure of grabbing you, you understand what that's like. You just feel like this little planet that's just not going to move. But I am moving, it's just not using you against you. So the better you get at it, the same thing when a big guy goes, pitch up and he's running you into the wall, you know what to do. So this technique works. So you're actually learning, you know, fighting people in close range conditions and pulling out all the stops. So you have a whole armament of technique when you stand in front of someone. You should never be standing in front of somebody and saying, oh, if I hit him, is he going to go down? You have all this stuff that you can do, and it's really easy. How you hit where you design your hits. So you got somebody like Lang, I want to stand with him, this tough guy, and how I come with this motion, which is going, my hands, my fingers go right into here, it's going down. About the protector when he's fighting, he gets scared and he's breaking on. Watch it without the sound. Just wait for the sound, snaps, and cracks, and pops. And just watch the technique. What you see, what it's doing in the movie, is he's using the people's own body weight to manipulate them. So you see, he's fighting all these guys, but they're all relatively the same size as him. Then when he fights the big guys, he's like the big ones. But then there's a scene where he takes the little things, the little knives, and just working on the tissue, it's the same thing with your hands. You're working on a different tissue, different things, the same way. So as you bring down all these variables come into play, you really start working and understanding the miracle of what your body's doing. Remember, your body's a vessel. All the energy's inside, you just gotta learn to project it and how to use it. You guys like today's class? Tough, right? Tough class. All classes have a point, and then what we'll do is we'll try to get some people to learn before. Work on this stuff, and I think we've got a good system. Now you're working with two things. As I look around here, you know, I see most, you know, nonviolent people, people with intellect, and victims. I see victims, people I would love to rob, beat up, take their money, right? If I was on the street, right? So that's what people have got to see. You know, unless it looks like we have no money. And if I'm a gang member and I'm told to hit a certain person, then everybody gets to hit. So with this technique, you're going to learn how to defend against people that you normally cannot defend against in mortal combat.